use.
So what everybody wants. 300.
Yes.
Of course you are.
We'll stuff. We're gonna separate your calibers and give them out to people.
Yeah, she had a J.C. Higgins, a Sears in the Roebuck 410.
Yeah, I would be impressed. I'll tell you what.
And there's nothing in there. Take a dry fire shot. And then nice, easy, steady trigger pull. So let's get you set up. Okay, 2690. So
took it right away.
Yeah.
And that's a 265 grain?
Yeah. That is not the buffalo, but it'll be close enough. Let's not run through the buffalo ones.
Yeah.
To start with. We went through a bunch of reds.
Wombuta, what are we hunting today?
Well, basically it's our first morning, so we aren't do anything that have a heartbeat, I should say. So let's see what we find first.
You got it done. Very nice.
That was cool. That was very cool. I even got a picture.
I just thankful you let me shoot one in turn.
Well done. Oh, beautiful boy, and you must have shot him through the heart.
Yeah, I think
as near as I could figure. I couldn't see the shoulder real well. Okay. But as near as I figured, not that far behind it.
Yeah, he was angled just a little bit.
Yeah.
So here we are, not even noon on your first morning in Africa.
Right.
And you have the kind of eland bull people only dream about shooting.
For sure, I dreamt about it.
So what was that like? What was it like to see that thing?
It was exciting. You know, I mean, first day in Africa, never seeing an eland before. It's real exciting.
Unbelievable. Such a great old bull. He's worn down. He's got that great hair mop on his forehead that you look for. And incredible neck. These are just amazing animals.
Huge animal.
So now he goes with your moose.
Yeah.
These are perfect to go bookends in your TV room.
Right. I wished he was going in the freezer, but that's not possible.
He'll go in our bellies even better.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Gary. That is incredible bull. What a great morning.
Thank all of you, actually.
What a great morning.
It is.
Yeah. Excellent. Excellent. Excellent.
I've got a model
430.
Way better than.
I know where one's at. There's a model 54 270 in Montrose car. I don't know.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. It's just B2 car.
We've got some chicken there, and we've got some Impala sausage dinner.
Yeah. So yours are 54, but Josh got me a 54.
Matthew! I think we saw this herd a while ago. I'm pretty sure it's the same herd. We probably walked around for an hour or more. I think we spotted them, and then we started sneaking up, you know, being real quiet. Ig was being real quiet. I wasn't being so quiet. But then, you know, we lined up a shot. After a long while, and took him down. He didn't run very far, and that was that. That's a very nice, beautiful Eland bull. That's amazing. Wow. Look at him.
Go there. Austin, congratulations on a beautiful Eland bull. It's got excellent horn size, and it's got that hair on the face that we were talking about and what I was looking for. We were tracking, we saw some Eland this morning early. We left that group and we were tracking these herd of bulls for a while, for about 2 hours. And we caught up to them. You made a really good shot. Bit before you shot the Eland, you were a little bit dragging feet. I know it's a long walk and everything, but
yeah worth it.
You worked for it, and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank okay. you.
You would like to say something?
It's a big animal. I'll say that much. It's a great experience out here. I don't think I'll ever forget this. This is some of the coolest hunting I've ever done. Great to have a guide like you.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
balance hunting and shooting.
Okay, so I'm glad we got that out of the way.
Out of the way? We missed.
Lucky Pops and 11 brothers.
What's going on yet?
Hmm?
What?
What do we have?
Is this what? Elan?
Yeah. Elan Phillip.
Elan Phillip.
Yeah. Nice and yellow.
Morning.
What are we shooting?
Well, you left us for 3 days now, and then you realize that there's no better hunting crew than the crew you're with today again. You decided you have to get some footage. Yeah, she has to get some footage, and the other guys doesn't shoot anything because they're not capable. So you decided to come back to your roots, come back to Team A, and we're gonna shoot try for a black water beast and a lead tree. So we're gonna do that quickly and then go back to camp to have coffee and then decide what we're gonna shoot next.
Well, yesterday's the only time I saw our plan happen. I mean, you said we'll go after a kudu, then we'll go after a gemsbuck, and we got a kudu and then we got a gemsbuck.
We're lucky.
beautiful bull.
Looks like a like a water buck, you know, exactly the same shape of horns. There you got it. Well done.
Come, Gary. You can talk.
Okay. This is like the seventh animal that I've shot, and you'd think that probably it's getting to where it's not exciting. However, that's not so. It is exciting. And each animal's been a very beautiful, beautiful animal, beautiful experience.
Yeah. No, well done. We found this animal, saw it them early this morning, walked on them a bit, and we got lucky and he stepped into a little gap there, and Uncle Gary made a perfect shot. And here it is. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Gary.
Thank you.
Perfect. Beautiful animal.
Thank you.
Get much bigger, better.
No. If he's going to be big, he needs to be in the road.
Well done, well done.
Oh. It took three, but the second shot was exactly on 260 meters.
That's a long way.
So I told her to put it on the spine, and maybe she just
went over
it. And it just nicked it here on the back.
Okay.
Yeah. Just nicked it on the back, and
so you still hit it all three shots.
He is terrifically patient. Gary got an animal, and he said there were black wildebeests over there, and I had to get one. And I panicked, and everybody said I had to anyway. And so,
I found it.
So they decided that there was, it was close enough I could walk there. And so I followed closely, and he found a perfect tree with a crotch for me to put the gun in.
Yeah, it was perfect, wasn't it?
It was, the right height,
everything. As if it was put there for you.
God put it there for me.
Great.
And then he told me where to shoot, and to be gentle with the trigger, and I hit it. And then he told me where to hit it again.
And 260 meters, which was quite a far shot.
And then I was a little high on the next one. And then we got him here.
Well done.
Thank you.
Beautiful animal.
You are very patient and helpful and perfect.
Pleasure. You did it perfectly. Huh? Congratulations. Yes.
No.
What a beauty. Thank you. Congratulations, Matthew.
Thank you. Holy cow.
You know you judge these. Oh. You see the all it's all cracked up.
Yes.
But then you look at the drop. It goes past the ear. It goes up again. It's level with the bosses on top.
Okay.
This is a great one.
Thank you. Wow.
So we saw these from the truck. We got out and we were stalking them for a little while, just staying low. We tried to stay behind a tree. We followed him out and started getting lower and lower, started crouching and crawling up on next to him.
Yeah.
And I took my first shot up against a tree. It was not a very stable shot. I missed that one. They ran a little ways over here. My second shot was up on a branch of the tree with it stabilizing my elbow, and it was a much, much better shot. I hit him. He was facing towards me, hit him in the neck, and then he ran a little ways. The other one went and checked him out. And as we were coming up to him, we actually, the other one was still here.
The young bull.
Yeah. And so we just came up, and a beautiful animal, very, very fun hunt. Absolutely gorgeous animal. Yeah, pleasure to do this.
Yeah, you made a good shot, Matthew, and it's really a beautiful bull, old bull. It's got a nice curve on it and nice, beautiful tips going upwards. It's a beautiful trophy. Congratulations on a good hunt.
Thank you.
Morning, Momkali. What are we hunting today?
We are looking for a game buck and a blue wildebeest today. And then this afternoon we'll go after this buffalo here.
Morning. Morning, Sam. Are you ready?
Ready.
Hello, Wimbuta. What are we hunting?
Well, we went for bushbuck in Impala this morning. Completed our mission, and it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon now, and we're going to see if we can find a buffalo for Uncle Gary here. What do you have to say, Uncle Gary?
Well, we find a buffalo.
Of course. Right.
It'll make Josh happy.
Yeah. Shoot the buffalo and Josh can see if his bullets perform.
Thank you.
That smells good.
Does it?
Whatever it is, it smells good.
This is pork chops.
Pork chops.
And I think, I don't know if this is Eland or Gimsbach sausage.
This is the morning of the seventh day. We're off after buffalo. My dad's got one located here. He's shooting his 364 Winchester with a 375. He's using our deep impact bullets. They don't mushroom much past like a 45 caliber, but they drive really deep. They've done well on Eland and then a buffalo last night. So we're hopeful we're gonna hit one this morning.
Thank you, sir.
That's a beautiful bull.
Congratulations. That's gonna be one of the biggest small bulls.
Grin and Polish saw it. We drove off about a half a mile and then walked back. And Buta saw it. I was standing there. He said, shoot it when it gets up. I couldn't see where it was. He just told me where it was. I pointed the gun in that general direction. And when it stood up, I saw him and was able to shoot him. And then Judge shot him. And he didn't go very far. He went maybe 200 yards and died. So great hunt, great bull. I didn't have any adrenaline on anything else I shot in here, but I had plenty of adrenaline for this. Even an old man like me can still make adrenaline.
Nice shooting, great Dad. Hunt. Great bull.
Yeah.
He's super wide. He's out past the ears. He has a phenomenal boss. Boss is really good.
He doesn't
has
have his hook still. His hygiene's not good.
Yeah. Yeah. Good duggable.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
That is amazing. I didn't think I would get a bull to start with. Figured I was too old to do that, but this is great. I didn't have to do a whole lot. Point of gun.
From the looks of him right now, I think you're paying the upcharge. He's a big bull.
Anyway, we were found a bull. Josh found a bull yesterday in this neck of the woods, which is a fenced off pretty small area compared to a lot of the rest of them, and not near as brushy. So we came in here last night and we saw the bull, knew it was a good bull, and came in today and started tracked it for an hour or two, and then we were driving and Yandre and Pola saw the bull, and so we parked half a mile away and walked back through, and Buta saw the bull. He told me where to point the gun. I never saw the bull until it stood up, but we ended up getting the bull. Josh and I both made shots on it, and it went down after 200-300 yards and was an easy bull hunt, easy buffalo hunt. So real exciting.
We saw coming up to it, there's a bush halfway to where the bull was. There's a hole in the bush, and you could just see a horn tip and a little glisten off the boss in the sun. And so it waited, like you said, just maybe 3 minutes for it to stand up. When it stood up, Dad shot. I sent one its way. I'm not sure I hit it ever, but I sent one after it as it turned and ran. Made it, like you said, 100 yards or so. It's got a good hit on it, and looks like the bullets performed well. He was shooting a 375 H&H with a 300 grain, what we're calling our deep penetration round. It's meant to go expand very little, but drive deep. Looks like it worked on this one because he was making a death bellow within maybe 10 seconds. It wasn't far, ran a little bit and was down in the spot. We sent two more in, more for ballistic testing after that. But anxious to get him skinned and see how the bullets did.
Okay, so me and Collie are here to talk about a buffalo hunt. This is my first time to Africa, and you have expectations before the hunt of how things will play out. And in full honesty, this was not like any of that. I thought we had buffalo the first morning, right in range, that didn't quite work out. And 6 days later of chasing Collie through some of the most thorns and tight brush and
a lot of thick stuff,
failed attempts on stalks. And I think the whole theme of this hunt was bad wind. Everywhere we went, we would work our way into good wind to get close to buffalo, to get our backs breezed on, to have bad wind. And we worked and worked and worked at it. And on the sixth day of an eighth-day hunt, we finally found buffalo and were able to stalk within range of two good hard-boss bulls. Made a shot on one bull that wasn't the optimal shot. And throughout the entire trip, we'd been talking about how this would transpire and how this would play out. And I didn't know that it would be like this, but made a shot on a bull to have it disappear in the brush with Collie's hunting partner, Caprivi, close in tow.
Yeah, he went in, I think he had two scuffles with it.
Yeah.
He ran up to it, had a little bit of a scuffle. You could hear the buffalo running away again, had another little scuffle. And then I think from there on, the buffalo didn't want to turn around to fight again.
Yep.
He just kept on running. I think he ended up running a good maybe 2.5 miles.
Yep. And as a first trip to Africa, inexperienced hunter, my heart sank when the buffalo crossed one road,
yeah,
and the next road. And I don't speak Afrikaans, but I could tell that the situation was not looking awesome. And we had Collie in the front at pretty much a run for over a mile, maybe 2 miles, chasing this buffalo that we could hear, that Caprivi could get into it. We could hear the buffalo blow back out. But then I started picking up things. Kali showed me that the buffalo was dragging its left front foot. And then I started feeling better. And then a downside, the buffalo stopped bleeding.
What made it a little bit better, or I would say what made me feel a little bit better, is Caprivi running about 50 to 60 yards in front of us, and then he would kind of clear everything there, and then he would wait for us there, and then he would proceed another 50 or 60 yards. So that kind of gave us that feeling that the buffalo is not waiting for us, you know, for that about 2 miles.
Again, as a rookie hunter and someone that's never hunted dangerous game, that felt really good, because all I could see was black shadows where the buffalo could be hiding. But once we saw Caprivi go through, I felt very good that we knew that that place was able to go through without having the buffalo right there. But we finally got into thick enough stuff that we could hear Caprivi and the buffalo having a chase through it, and we knew we were close, within 100 yards or less. And then we were on the tracks, and the excitement started to build. And I think at that point, I couldn't hear what you guys were saying, but I didn't know the shot was good, bad, or different. But I knew we were getting closer, so my hope was that the buffalo was either getting tired, it was hurt badly, whatever it was, we were getting closer. And then we finally came on the tracks, and I saw Collie's head turn to the left, I turned to the left, Frecky turned to the left, there's the buffalo.
Yeah, and then in my mind, I felt like it's going to be between us within the next second. So instinctively, my footing was not even right, and I had the wrong foot forward because we were still tracking it in one direction.
But tracking it at almost a jog.
Yeah. And then what happened is he circled us. So he came from our left side on about, 40 feet?
Yeah, we said it was 15 meters.
Yeah, 15 meters.
Yeah.
And then instinctively, what I just did is I just picked my gun up, fired a shot at him, with you guys following immediately.
Well, I think me and Frecky were following Collie, and so when we saw Collie's head turn and the gun come up, our guns instinctively followed that as well.
Yeah, because there was the problem there, I think, was there was like a small little passage that wide that I could see him coming through, and you guys had a bush in front of you.
Yeah.
So you guys were looking through that bush and shooting through that bush. We even afterwards we went to look, and there was a lot of branches that was broken from your bullets going through the bush, into the buffalo.
Yeah, and so Collie's first shot, Collie is shooting a .458 Winchester Magnum, 500 grain solid.
Yeah.
First shot, I honestly think could not have been better. That was the shot of the trip. Entered the buffalo in the nostril, traveled into the cavity somewhere. But what I thought when I saw the buffalo get up was, this buffalo has it full power. he looked very alive.
Yeah.
Collie's first shot made the buffalo look like now we had a chance. What we said later was the playing field got even after the first shot.
Yeah.
I think within just moments of your shot, my shot went off. The .416
Frecky's shot
with Frecky.
Yeah.
I was shooting a .375 H&H with G9 300 grain solids. Frecky's shot went off. You put one more, I believe, there. I put one more, and then the buffalo got back to the ground.
Yeah.
At that point, we knew that there was still life in it, and the brush was so thick that the ability to get to the buffalo that way was not an option. We had to traverse around a small group of brush to get in behind it. Kali advised me to get two in behind the right shoulder, which we did in rapid succession. And at that point, I think we all knew we were walking away alive. It was interesting too, because throughout the whole trip, Kali and I had been talking about the difference of a client gun to a guide gun. I'm shooting a .375, Kali's shooting a .458, and the explanation now was completely clear to me, to watch what a well-placed .458 was able to do on a very much alive buffalo.
Yeah.
It was impressive. Good shooting. Thank you for taking care of that for me.
One of the most memorable and I think probably the toughest buffalo hunts I've ever done.
6 days of, Collie and I are both 6'2", 6'3", and everywhere the buffalo goes is built for someone that's 5'5". And
yeah, only even shorter like yeah, that.
Right. And so we put miles and miles, and luckily Collie's in fantastic shape, so he was able to keep us going day after day to get, and the thing of it was the excitement level was always high because we had buffalo with us all the time, it seemed like. We were never without buffalo, just yeah, with bad wind.
Buffalo every session.
Yeah.
We bumped two or three different groups every time.
And I can think of a number of ways that a buffalo hunt can get spoiled, and I think we had all of them. We had kudu in between us and buffalo. We had eland in between us and buffalo. We had buffalo in between us and buffalo.
Yeah.
We had some smaller bulls. We had a broadside soft boss bull at 20 paces and a hard boss bull that wouldn't turn broadside. So we experienced it all, but I'm at one point I considered that this was going to be an unsuccessful hunt, and I'm really happy for the way it turned out. So and I'm really grateful that you shoot a 458 like you do.
That was an honor hunting with
you. Likewise. This is going to happen again. So, but just an excellent hunt and a great bull. And the exciting thing was too that. As a client, I didn't get a good look at the bull until it was on the ground, and I couldn't have been happier with what a good bull.
Fantastic trophy.
Yeah, yeah, just a great bull. But all in all, just a adrenaline filled.
The way a buffalo one should be like.
Yeah, yeah. You know what though? If the next one's easier, I'm okay with it. So I won't complain. Yeah, it was fantastic. Thank you again. It was good.
For me, what are we barbecuing tonight?
Some pork chops.
Zebra.
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 Ja, to the in Afrikaans we would say Manki family. Thank you for the week. Thank you for meeting you guys. We had a really good time with you, and you've got a great family, and you're always welcome at Dylan Force every time.
Thank you.
So I just want to say thank you, and yeah, for you really. I'm going to frame Afrikaans if that's okay. Yes, that's yours.
We are going to go for a walk, and we're going to look for a blazebuck, a possible wolf, springbuck, and maybe a black wildebeest.
Great morning. Started out looking for impala, springbuck, black wildebeest. Happened to come across the blessed buck here. Had very shifty, non-favorable wind again, but Collie was able to spot him from about 300 out. We made a sneak in, got to within 100, 150, shooting the 375 with G9 300 grain premium soft points. Got the shot a little far forward on the entrance shoulder, right through the exit shoulder. No tracking involved. The blessed buck died right here. So it was a great morning. Thank you very much, Colin.
Congratulations, and thank you for hunting with Premium Safaris.
Thank you.
fantastic.
Okay, we just had success on a black wildebeest here. Collie spotted him from about 400 yards out, played the wind right, and was able to stalk within about 50 yards. He had the largest bull located, shooting the 375 H&H with G9, 300 grain premium soft. Was able to get one right behind the shoulder. Good vital shot. It traveled about 60 yards, and here we are. So thank you very much, Collie.
Congratulations. Beautiful shot.
Thank you.
Good. Like all the beast.
Okay, our good luck continues today. Just was able to connect with a springbuck here. Spotted him and moved through some brush here, and finally was able to get him in the open. And close shot, quick shot, shooting the 375 H&H with G9's 300 grain premium soft points. Worked great. Thank you, Collie.
Congratulations on a beautiful springbuck.
Thank you.
Beautiful springbuck. He didn't even know that he was big.
Thank you. Well done.
Beautiful male.
Nice shot,
well
Matthew.
Done, young man.
Amazing shot.
Well done.
Thank you. I want to check my gun.
That's good.
I pulled it up and bashed the scope into the tailgate.
Good.
This is us, this gun. My gun is not shooting.
Great. We went out this afternoon. The young guys decided to shoot a springbuck each. Austin got his first and he made a nice shot a little high on the shoulder. And then it was Matthew's turn. He made an even higher shot also on the shoulder. Let's be honest with each other, the skins are worthless. But You just gonna have to come again and let me shoot you each springbuck. But we'll do that. Congratulations, guys. This is our last day I hope you guys enjoyed it a lot, and hope to see each other again in future.
Very much so. It has been a true pleasure being here. We've very much so enjoyed it. You've been very warm to all of us, and it's truly been an amazing experience. A great way to conclude the hunt. So thank you.
Great pleasure.
Thank you,
thank you
so much.
Pleasure.
Yeah. We just decided to give him a job since he can't pay his bow. He shot too many animals.
Oh, Grandma wanted to shoot that one, and Chip told him no, or Chip told her no.
Whoa.
Eland hybrid over there. His horns look spiral.
Yeah.
They are spiral.
Well, like, I don't know.
Yeah, this one.
Very, very old man. Look how this one is. Yeah. Very nice. Look at how old he is. Look here.
Yeah.
He's a very old man.
We had a good hunt. We just hunted some springbucks. And that was a whole lot of fun. I just said, you know, if we have time, let's do a blessed buck. And so we went after him. We drove not very far. We spotted a few of them. We kind of drove around. We saw some eland, some a golden wildebeest. Had a good time and found him again. Got off the truck. Found one we liked and shot it. It was a pretty simple hunt, but a great experience nonetheless. My shot placement was a little low, but this G9 156 grain bullet, 30 cal, did a really good job. Helped me out. It was just a fun time.
Great. Do I have to say something? I think you said it all, but anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, congratulations on a beautiful, very, very old blazebuck ram.
Thank you.
You made a good shot on him, and yes, congratulations, young man.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can go to the Marines, huh? You're fine. You'll hit the target.
Yeah.
Good.
I'm going up, and then they're going to go in. Ready? Give the horns to me, watch out.